guys, what's up? It's Sama. Today I thought it'd be fun if we got to watch. I filmed myself watching the Folklore like pawn live sessions because I realized this is the first time I have ever really been able to sit down and listen to Taylor talk through the process of every single song on an album, I think. And I, like, who wouldn't want to record that, you know? So I just wanted to have this for memories. So we're just gonna get right into it. All right, I have got my cappuccino, my Folklore hoodie on, and I am ready to just cry. Oh my god, I'm so excited. I've heard a few spoilers because I fell asleep last night before the release. Yeah, so I know a few spoilers, mostly just about Joe being William Bowery, which is so, so cute. Oh my god.
Quarantine, and then it just became an album really quickly and really, really kind of beautifully. Really not that special, but I'm freaking out over it. The other side of the wall, Laura! Hey, yeah, Jack, it's like you're right there, but instead you're in New York.
Like, this is how the album came together.
That's I'm freaking out. We've never done that.
I already know I'm gonna cry so much. Like, that's so crazy that the entire album was made in complete isolation. Oh my god.
First day we've been in the same room.
Cheers. Yeah.
First moment.
That's so weird.
I love Jack.
When lockdown happened, Jack. I just...
I don't know if this is a real text. I'm not... Seemed like a bit.
I think one conversation with Jack and Taylor could solve all my life problems.
I didn't even tell my label until... a week before we put it out.
What was that call like?
It was amazing. I thought it was gonna be stressful, and I thought I was gonna have to kind of stand up. Whatever you want to make, like, we're down.
You ready to play this whole thing?
It's so crazy to me that, like, Taylor's
yeah,
like,
no, I think it's really
permission.
Important that we play it. I think it will take that for me to realize that it's a real album. I was so glad that we did, because it turned out that, like, everybody needed a good cry as well as us.
Like, mentally, I knew that the one was gonna be first, but it's harder now that I know what this first track is like, but this one breaks me.
I'm doing good, I'm on some new shit. Been saying yes instead of no. I thought I saw you at the bus stop, I didn't though.
Hey, I knew I was gonna cry, but not this early.
You know the greatest films of all time were never made. And if you never bleed, you're never gonna grow. That's all right now. If my wishes came true, it would've been you.
This line breaks me for some reason.
You meet some woman on the internet and take her home. You know the greatest loves of all time are over now.
It's the way I would never actually be able to go to the secret sessions because I'm a mess. And she'd be like, what is wrong with you? She'd walk in and I'd be like, her eyeliner's so pretty. How did they not cry while singing this? I'd be like, miss
it was funny because I feel like you just the way it opens.
Also, I love Aaron Dessner. Like, I really hope they work together more in the future. I'm obsessed with this record.
Writing songs with me and.
This song has grown on me so much, especially the bridge and final chorus. It just, the song makes me feel like I'm running out of time, and oh.
Said I was.
forget that this is track two. I don't know why, but the last Great American Dynasty gives me track two vibes for some reason. Anyway, I'm not doing well. We're not even to the saddest part. I think this is me trying to actually gonna kill me. Why does it feel like I'm listening to this for the first time? Like, I have heard every single one of these songs a million times since July. Crazy to me to think that if the pandemic had never happened, we would not have these songs. This is such a bittersweet moment. I hate the pandemic. I wish it never happened. But I'm like, what would my life be without this album? I feel horrible saying that.
I think this is my moment. I think I can write the Rebecca Harkness story.
That song is such a folklore moment to me because it's not about you, but it is all about you.
Well, it's that, like, country music kind of narrative device. Yes. Where in country music it's like, this guy did this, then this woman did this,
yeah,
then they met, and their kid was me.
Totally. Like, yeah. And I was that man.
Yeah,
that
I was that kid.
But
which is the best. It's like you listen to country songs and you're just totally, like, shiver everywhere,
true.
My whole body.
Like,
I hate country
not
music sometimes, but like that storytelling is
else,
good.
I think it's the most revealing thing.
Yeah.
I think it's so deeply personal.
Yeah.
It really
I love this track.
Hear that at the end.
Yes.
Thanks.
Who says you can't dance to folklore?
Rebecca rode up on the afternoon train. It was sunny. Her sawbox house on the coast took her mind off St. Louis. And money. And the town said, how did a middle class divorcee do it? The parties were tasteful, beef a little loud. The doctor had told him to settle down. Her fall is hard to hear. And they said, there goes the last great American dynasty. She had a marvelous time ruining everything.
I love that line. Like, I want to live my life like that line.
Fill the pool with champagne, swim with the big names, blew through the money on the boys and the
valet.
Game bets with Dolly. They say she was seen on occasion pacing the
like this part. I love this bridge. Chills when she says that. Chills. I would drop everyone in the world if she asked me to. Everybody. Absolutely everybody. Ruin my own life for her. Oh my god. Oh my god, you hear those little problems.
My two co-writers were here. Justin Vernon and William Bowery.
Justin is one of the greatest ever ever got to meet.
There's been a lot of discussion about William Bowery and his identity, because it's not a real person.
It's not?
Shut up, Jack. Shut up. That's not even funny. That's not even funny.
That would have gone on forever.
What?
Who?
When?
So, William Bowery is Joe, as we know. And Joe plays piano beautifully, and he's always just playing and making things up and kind of creating things. And
are you kidding?
Exile was crazy because Joe had written that entire piano part, that dun 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 dun, and it was singing the Bon Iver part, that I can see you standing by
me,
whose arms around your body, laughing, but the joke's not funny at all. And
I,
Yeah, he was just singing it Jesus. The way that the whole first verse is.
Wow. Are you kidding me right now? No, because she's really found someone who wants to write music with her. I am so happy for her. Oh my god.
This is hopefully a duet. I don't know who with.
That's so cute.
Would it be with? Because if I would have said it and he would have gone to Justin and Justin would have said no,
oh no.
It would hurt too much.
No. She's so cute.
We talked about it. I was like, I think he's going to be really.
You got so step right out. There is no
shut
out. Like that whole.
I'm gonna be honest, I didn't know Bon Iver was a 7-member band until yesterday. One of my Twitter mutuals told the timeline, really. I was very shocked. That line breaks me, and then the same line that Taylor sings. I can see you staring at me. This line gets me. I can see you staring, honey, like he's just your understudy. Like you'd get your knuckles bloody for me.
Second, third, and hundredth chances. Balancing on breaking bridges. I think I've seen this film before. And I didn't like the ending.
This line.
I'm not sure problem anymore. So who am I?
I deserve to hear this live. This in a stadium would absolutely break me. This bridge. Tears ricochet. Oh my god.
Where do we start? To me, the whole thing starts with My Tears Ricochet.
Yeah, chronologically, that's the first thing. I wrote that one alone.
That would be the first one she writes.
It's definitely, I think, one of the saddest songs on the album.
Great, but sometimes you write like very in the moment.
Yeah.
And you're like, this happened and this is how I feel. And I love that. But this song, which is interesting that it's the first one that happened because I think it became a huge theme on the album, is it's very pulled back.
Mm-hmm.
It's very pulled back and commenting on the whole experience of it.
Except I don't think I would ever be able to have a conversation with those two. Like, I'd be in the room like, hi, song good, cry me, like, oh, here we go, god.
I didn't have it in myself to go with grace. And you're the hero flying around saving face. And if I'm dead to you, why are you at the wake? Cursing my name, wishing I stay. Look at how my tears ricochet.
I'm like crying.
I didn't have it in myself to go with grace. Cause when I'd fight you, you used to tell. To kill me, but it killed you just the same.
decisions. When you can see yourself being both sides. Look at all of my tears. Oh God. Every day this woman wakes up and chooses violence every single day.
The songs that reference each other or lyrical parallels, and one of the ones that I like is the entire song "This Is Me Trying" then being referenced again in Mirrorball, which is "I've never been a natural, all I do is try."
Yeah, I remember that being an interesting one for you to actually put down. I remember you said it and you did it and you were like, should I say that?
Like, is that too true? Is that? And I think, everybody feels like they have to be on for certain people. You have to be different versions of yourself for different people, different versions at work, different versions around friends, different versions of yourself around different friends.
This is like one of the most...
Different version of yourself around family. Everybody has to be duplicitous, or feels that they have to, in some ways, be duplicitous. And that's part of the human experience, but it's also exhausting. And you kind of learn that every one of us has the ability to become a shapeshifter.
Totally.
What does that do to us? And it also is the first time, and one of the only times that the time that we're living through was actually lyrically addressed. Mm-hmm. I think that, you know, the pandemic and lockdown and all that, what we are as humans, blah, blah, blah. But this is the first time in the bridge saying they called off the circus, burned the disco down, when they sent home the horses and the rodeo clowns. I wrote this song right after I found out all my shows were canceled. And it's like, I'm still on that tightrope. I'm still trying everything to get you laughing at me. So it's like, I realize here I am writing all this music, still trying. And I know I have an excuse to sit back and not do something, but I'm not, and I can't, and I don't know why that is.
Yeah, you don't get it. Pandemic time work is that it's not about the pandemic. It's about the experience of what happens to an artist when you're living through a pandemic.
Yeah, you start
to dream.
It reminds me of Low Story Loki too.
Me before I learned civility, like I used to scream anytime I wanted. Obviously, you know, we can't be throwing tantrums all the time, and we learned that that's not the right thing to do, but there's something lost there too.
The line "I hit my peak at 7" resonates so hard. Considering I found Taylor at 7, yeah, you got some serious childhood trauma if this is your favorite song off Folklore. Like, serious. August, we're getting into some dangerous territory now.
To work with you. And now Aaron can understand it. No, I'm serious, because it's like, here's the song. Oh wait, here's the bridge. Wait, here's a better bridge. Okay, now I'm perfect bridge. And then here's the thing after the bridge. This thing's gonna come in.
I remember when I pulled. I wrote that in the vocal booth.
Yes.
Yeah.
So there's a series of.
Just in case you call.
So like, but hearing the patchwork of like that whole thing coming together, I was just like, I just love. What you did on that song.
Thanks. I love what you did on that song. And I've been kind of in my head, like, calling the girl from August either Augusta or
nice.
Augustine. I've just been, like, naming her that in my head.
Well, that changes things for me. She's written nameless to me, but now it's forever changed.
Who would have up together, right? So in my head, she ends up with him, but he really put her through it. But, like, August was obviously about the girl that James had this summer with,
this, like,
right?
Entire
so
love triangle.
Girl, but really, she's not a bad girl. She's, like, really a sensitive person who, like,
shut up, shut up, shut up. We literally, girl, I wrote Betty from the perspective of Augustine. So if you want to check that out, Taylor, I had some similar ideas too, just saying.
She fell for him, and she was trying to seem cool and seem like she didn't care because that's what girls have to do. And she was trying to let him think that she didn't care, but she really did, and she thought they had something very real. And then he goes back to Betty.
I am so invested in August, like...
So the idea that there's some, like, some bad villain girl in any type of situation who, like, takes your man is actually a total myth, because that's not usually the case at all. Like, everybody
yes,
has
yes,
friends
yes.
and wants to be seen.
Yes, yes, yes.
But Augustine, that's all she wants.
That's what I love about August is, like, it's not a dream. Even though it sort of sounds like it, like it's like it feels, like the situation feels very close to me, like getting swept up like that.
That whole song started with the fact that I had written down in my phone, "Meet me behind the mall," years ago, wanting to write it into a song.
Like, I am so invested in this love triangle. I will randomly listen to this and just cry. These three songs kill me. Jack really loves August, like you can tell. Like, Jack is getting so into it. Audio recording as the only source of my happiness for like the next month, so thank you to you three. Jack is so cute. Oh my god, this is me trying. Oh my god,
I've been thinking about it, if they're either suffering through mental illness or they're suffering through addiction or they have an everyday struggle. No one pats them on the back every day, but every day they are actively fighting something. But there are so many days that nobody gives them credit for that.
Yeah.
And so how often must somebody who's in that sort of internal struggle must want to say to everyone in the room, you have no idea how close I am to going back to a dark place, or you have no idea.
You have no idea how hard it is to get to the point where you guys think is still shitty.
Yes.
Like, I think about that a lot. Like, the idea of doing your best or trying is one that only a person knows, and you know when you're doing it, and it's so hard, which is what I get from that song, when you're doing your damn best and it's not good enough.
Yep.
And it rarely is.
Yeah.
But it's you know, because, and then you've, it's a very isolating feeling, which I think is funny, because it actually is the thing that binds all of us. We're all like doing our best and feeling like it's not even close to good enough.
Yeah, I had this idea that the first verse would be about someone who is in a sort of a life crisis and has just been trying and failing and trying and failing in their relationship, has been, you know, messing things up with people they love, letting everyone down, has driven to this overlook, this cliff. It's just in the car going, I could do whatever I want in this moment and it could affect everything forever. But this person backs up and drives home. And
yeah, I love that. The idea that not driving off the cliff is an act of trying.
Yeah.
Which is almost the ultimate act of trying.
Yeah. And then the second verse is about, you know, someone who felt like they had a lot of potential in their life. I think there are a lot of mechanisms for us in our school days, in high school or college, to excel and to be patted on the back for something. And then I think a lot of people get out of school and there are less abilities for them to get gold stars.
Yeah.
And then you have to make all these decisions and you have to pave your own way, and there's no set class course you can take, and I think a lot of people feel really swept up in that. And so I was thinking about this, is really lost in life and then starts drinking and every second is trying not to.
I've been having a hard time adjusting. A lot of regrets about that. Pulled the car off the road to the lookout. Could have followed my fears all the way down. Maybe I don't quite know what to say. I'm here in your doorway. I just wanted you to know that this is me trying. All my potential and my words should take kill when I'm not. I have a lot of regrets about that. Classmates and I ended up here. Pouring out my heart to a stranger, but I didn't pour the whiskey. I just wanted you to know that this is me trying.
Bro, how did she not cry saying that?
It to me feels like a completely
bro, I probably look like such a mess right now. Oh my god.
What started in beautiful rooms ends with meetings in parking lots. And that's the thing about illicit affairs and for what they are.
Changing to a reputation for the last one felt too confining. Oh god, here we go.
Don't call me kid, don't call me baby. Look at this godforsaken mess that you made me. You show me colors you know I can't see with anyone else.
I love this song so much.
Was the color of the grass where I used to read in Centennial Park. Bold was the waitress on a 3-year trip getting lunched on.
As long as you're so happy, because I really do love the idea of like an invisible nurturing and like your cat life kind of being planned out for you. I think about all those times in the past when I was younger and I like swore I would never do something or never act a certain way, and now I realize that's exactly what I've turned into, and it's not necessarily a bad thing, but it's like, who would have thought that this is where life would have led me? I kind of feel emotionally numb after This Is Me Trying. Like, she really killed me with that explanation and the song in general. Oh god, not Mad Woman, not Mad Woman.
Mad Woman, the first time I heard that piano thing you had written, I just felt like,
yeah, this song makes me really sad.
What did you think I'd say to that? Does it slow me and sting when fighting back they strike?
And I love the play on words with mad, crazy, mad, angry. It's like so simple, but
neighbor's lawn, does she smile? What does she
They did not censor it. Girl, why did you choose Disney Plus? They did not just censor that. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me?
But you know I won't. And women like hunting witches to call me crazy again, more crazy. What about that?
Her singing is so enchanting. I just can't take my eyes off her. She's a performer.
Epiphany.
I think I really felt like there should be a string moment on the album because we were towards the end of it and it was all very... When I heard it, I remember thinking maybe I want to tell a sports story because I had just watched The Last Dance. I was taking a 20-minute break in between shifts at a hospital who are having this kind of trauma happen to them right now that they will probably never want to speak about, you know? And so I just kind of thought, like, this is an opportunity to maybe tell that story.
Keep your helmet. With you I serve, with you I fall down. Hold your hand through plastic now. Talk, I think she's crashing out. With you I serve, with you I fall.
I cannot believe Taylor and Joe wrote this together. That makes me want to cry. It makes me love that even more. Why is Jack laughing? What does he know? What does he know? What does he know?
Entire fully formed chorus of Betty.
Are you kidding?
Yeah, you're like, I do this professionally.
Hello.
I'd love to have a conversation.
Have ever written a song together?
I thought you were doing a bit when you're like, Joe and I wrote a song, and I was like, what? And I thought it was gonna be like, you know, like people write like cute songs about their animals relationships, and then you're like, no, we wrote like a real song, and I'm like, what? And then you sent me.
So this was the first time we had a conversation.
That's so cute. Taylor, I wrote Betty from the perspective of August. If you want to check it out. Oh god, here we go.
Betty, I won't make assumptions about why you switched your homeroom, but I think it's cause of me.
Also, I just realized homeroom is like study hall. Not like a room in her home.
And so this song was basically like, is it enough? Is the stuff that I can control enough to sort of block out the things that I can't?
I go up and down, and I can't help it. It's like a chemical thing that happens sometimes. And music is a way of dealing with that for me. And just somehow that the song captures the fragility of what that's like to be.
A coming of age is come and gone. Suddenly this summer it's clear. Cold and darling, cause it lives in me. No, I could never give you peace. The devil's in the details, but you got a friend in me.
Okay, the word hoax is another word that I love. Cause I love that it has an X, and I love the way that it looks, and I love the way it sounds.
Yeah, I think you didn't. I think, like, to you it meant different things, and that was a moment of like doubt or something.
And I said not all of these feelings are about the same person. What if I'm writing about several different very fractured situations, like, you know, one is about love and one is about a business thing that really the thing that makes you uncomfortable, because I think that's what makes it a song that really to me stands out.
A sleepless night, my windless fight, this has frozen my ground. It stood on the cliffside screaming, give me a reason. Your faithless love's the only hoax I believe in. So I let you in the door. You knew you won, so what's the point of keeping score? Still hurts underneath my scars when they pulled me apart, but what you did was just the start.
Oh god, the lakes.
You've been writing about getting out forever.
Yeah, so the lakes is really talking a lot about relating to people who hundreds of years ago had the same exit plan and did it.
I've cried this to the song so much in like the last week.
Too far to watch something drop its sleeves. Tell me what are my words worth. Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong, my beloved, neither do you. I want auroras and saprobes. I want to watch wisteria grow.
Oh, it's over. So that marks the end of Folklore, the Long Pond Studio Sessions. As you can tell, that was a marvelous experience for me. Like, I literally bawled my eyes out. This album has just meant a lot to me in the past few months, and I'm just like really grateful that I have it right now. Taylor has and always will be my biggest inspiration, my biggest role model in more than just music. And I'm just so glad she shared this with us. If you can, please go watch it. It's such a good experience. Yeah, I would at least go listen to the audio recordings. I believe they're available on every platform. So yeah, Let me know what you guys thought of this. I'm gonna go cry some more, so.